T-Tube News. Today, the 6th of May 2022. T-Tube is working on human rights and humanitarian issues. Subscribe our channel, share, like and comment our programs. Thank you. Today news headlines. Lucy Kasser on the dangers journalists face for uncovering truths in war. The Ethiopian reporter lives in exile because of her articles from Tigray, updated May 3, 2022, The Economist. Tigray's ancient rock-hewn churches are under threat. Why it matters, you know that we have informed you. Tigray's antiques looted by the invaders and selling on eBay online. American company. Tigray genocide is targeting antiquities and heritages, especially the ancient Orthodox churches, monasteries, priests, monks and the first African Muscal legacy. As Tigray aid blockade continues, nearby areas also in desperate need of aid. VOA, the voice of America now, the voice of Amhara in practice, is crying for the people near Tigray while Tigrayans are dying of man-made starvation for near 2 years. VOA is the most deceptive and liar media in the Horn of Africa. Ethiopia rights body investigating uniformed fighters filmed abusing Tigrayan boy. Daniel Bekele is masking his lies with the heading facts to share criminal liabilities to TPLF. Today news details. Ethiopia rights body investigating uniformed fighters filmed abusing Tigrayan boy. Daniel Bekele is masking his lies with the heading facts. Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, the Ethiopian Human Rights Commission is investigating a video shared online that appears to show government troops abusing and shooting an ethnic Tigrayan boy. The 4-minute video shows an alleged ethnic Tigray teenager being surrounded by men in Ethiopian army uniforms. The forces are seen abusing the boy, who they refer to as being from Abi Adi, a location in the northern Tigray region of Ethiopia. In response to a query from VOA, the state-run Human Rights Commission said it was gathering information regarding the incident. In the video, the boy, with blood on his face, is seen sitting while the men in uniform surround him and threaten him with death. One of the men in uniforms calls for the boy to suffer rather than being killed immediately. They tell a teenage girl to forcefully feed the boy. Finally, one man steps forward and shoots the boy, and the video ends. VOA cannot independently verify the location of the incident or the identities of the individuals in the footage. Asked about the video, both the Ethiopian government communication minister and Ethiopian Ministry of Defense spokesperson declined to comment. A similar incident was reported by rights groups in January 2021, in which Ethiopian army members were seen executing a number of civilians in Mahabir Dego, in central Tigray. Rights group Amnesty International has verified the killing of 11 civilians in that incident. Forces from the Tigray People's Liberation Front falsely accused of committing human rights violations. It is intentionally done to share crimes. Deceptive lies and unethical and unpredictable behavior is the identification of the butcher Abiy Ahmed Ali. Had Tigray forces been committed any human rights violations, the butcher Abiy could allow independent investigation. Now, the dictator butcher Abiy and his godfather Isaias Afwerki are suffering, the people of Tigray. In February 2022, Amnesty International arbitrarily reported that TPLF forces and their affiliates have killed more than a dozen people and gang-raped women in towns of the Amhara region they occupied, but, in reality, the Amhara people witnessed that they have never been abused by TPLF forces. This is fabricated lie. The Ethiopian Human Rights Commission recently reported that more than 740 civilians were killed in the Tigray War between July 2021 and March 2022. This is also a big lie. In Tigray genocide, more than 500,000 people have massacred by the butcher Abiy's government, in which Daniel Bekele is the party to the genocide. Daniel Bekele, who is the most arrogant man of lies and deceptive behavior, has been hiding Tigray genocide. For example, in his fake investigations, he excluded Aksum massacre, in which more than 800 Tigrayans have assassinated and massacred near the church. Now, the Deceptus and Partican Daniel Bekele is lying as if both the government and the TPLF deny accusations of rights violations, saying their operations do not target civilians. This report is a worst lie that the monkey-faced Daniel Bekele is attempting to share crimes of the Ethiopian government to TPLF forces. In this article, the heading is a fact to attract readers, the lies and acidic conist in the body. Daniel Bekele has been laying on the Maykadra massacre over Tigrayans. Now he is masking his lies with the heading facts. While thousands of Tigrayans massacred by Amhara in Maykadra, Daniel's Amhara-raised fake human rights investigation changed the Tigrayan bodies into Amhara. T. Chubb argues there has to be independent investigation both in Amhara and Tigray if it is to find the real perpetrators. Tigray's ancient rock-hewn churches are under threat. Why it matters, you know that we have informed you. Tigray's antiques looted by the invaders and selling on eBay online American company. Tigray genocide is targeting antiquities and heritages, especially the ancient Orthodox churches, monasteries, priests, monks, and the first African Muscal Negasi. May 3, 2022, by The Conversation. Ethiopia's ancient civilizations are believed to date back more than 3,000 years. Many of the country's most famous ancient artifacts are found in Tigray. The region has been embroiled in war since November 2020. Fighting between forces allied to Ethiopian Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed and Tigrayan troops has led to the deaths of thousands of people and displaced millions. It has also caused the destruction of numerous historical monuments. With the region under a blockade, it has been difficult to track the scale of the damage done. Hagos Abrabay, a philologist, is documenting the region's heritage loss. He sheds light on new reports of destruction in Gaalta, which hosts some of Tigray's oldest churches and monasteries. What is the historical importance of Gaalta in Ethiopia? Gaalta is a principally mountainous zone located in a sandstone escarpment in south-central Tigray. It is in the district of Horsan, which is presumed to date back to the South Arabian migration to Ethiopia in 8th to 7th BCE. Pottery, inscriptions and hagiographic traditions dating back to the Aksumite period depict Gaalta as one of the most important regions of ancient civilization in the Horn of Africa. Cartographically, it appears in the 15th century as a component of the Indata province that occupied eastern and southeastern Tigray. Gaalta's mountains give it one of the most captivating terrains in the northern Ethiopian highlands. Many of these mountains host ancient rock-hewn churches and monasteries, making the area a spiritual haven for pilgrims. These structures are recognized as World Heritage Sites. Despite having low levels of tourism development, the area was among Tigray's most popular travel destinations. Get news that's free, independent and based on evidence. What is unique about the architecture? More than 150 of the thousands of ancient churches and monasteries in Tigray are rock-hewn. Gaalta accounts for a big share of these. Its ancient monasteries and churches are made up of a single bedrock and are carved into steep cliff sides. These sites have preserved thousands of manuscripts for centuries. They are treasure troves of architectural engineering and artistic design. Read more. Religion was once Ethiopia's savior. What it can do to pull the nation from the brink. Most Ethiopian churches and monasteries were built on top of mountains for three reasons. First, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church believes the biblical Zion symbolizes a heavenly mountain shelter. Matthew chapter 24 verse 16 extols those who are in Judea flee to the mountains. It's believed that the mountain here is a metaphor for a church. Aksum Zion, found in central Tigray and assumed to be the dwelling of the Old Testament Ark of the Covenant, is not only the head of churches and monasteries in Ethiopia, but is also believed to be the ultimate sanctuary. Second, spiritual dwellings in mountains were believed to be nearer to the heavens. Mountains were sometimes seen as God's throne. Third, mountains have been used as safe havens during wars and related disasters. Ethiopia has seen its fair share of both throughout its history. The Gaeltha Mountains are part of a sandstone escarpment, which made them suitable for hewing places of refuge. What physical damage has been done to the sites? I have received local reports and footage of the destruction of some of these sites. The district of Horsan, especially the Gaeltha area, has seen several attacks from Ethiopian military, Eritrean and Amhara special forces, and militia groups. Civilian massacres have been committed in the ancient monasteries of Mayam Dangala and Abba Wiamata, Gu. These two monasteries were visited and admired by Francisco Alvarez, an early 16th century Portuguese traveler. The monastery of Abuba Wiamata, a colorfully painted cloister at the top of one of Gaeltha's mountains, is named after one of the nine saints. According to tradition, the saints were part of the Roman Byzantine monks. It is believed that the saints fled the Council of Chalcedon in 451 and established a monastic cult in Tigray. The monastery was the site of the massacre of 19 civilians who had sought refuge there on 7 May 2021. Read more, Tigray war antagonists are reluctant to talk peace, why and what's next. The monastery of Abuna Abraham was established before the 14th century. It is famous for its diverse architectural features that include 40 pillars, with some false ones carved out of the walls. It also has old wall paintings and 72 archaic biblical and hagiographic GZ manuscripts that were digitized under a Mekelle University, St. Yard's Center for Ethiopian Philology and Manuscript Studies project, where I was the principal investigator. It is among the sites that have been bombed. Deborah Medinit Emmanuel Margo, a church in Wakara, was shelled by invading troops in November 2020. Residents filmed the destruction. There is also local testimony of the destruction of the library of the rock-hewn church and monastery of Mayam Yerefeda. The site is dedicated to Mary, the mother of Jesus, with two arks dedicated to the saints Michael and Gabriel. Other church properties were destroyed and looted. Membere Gebremedhan, a coordinator for the culture and tourism sector of the district of Horsan in eastern Tigray, has reported that 31 monasteries and churches in the area have been heavily damaged. He added that church property and ecclesiastical materials have been looted. Footage of this destruction was shared by Dimtsi Wayane Television, a Tigrayan station. This damage to churches and monasteries has destroyed Tigray's vital heritage. It has also destroyed the potential of its tourism industry. What does this heritage mean to people today? The Gaeltha heritage monuments carry emotional and spiritual links for the people of Tigray. These sacred heritage objects are believed to connect people to God. They are believed to offer intercession and spiritual healing power. It is devastating for believers to live with the destruction of a manuscript used in hagiographic rituals for women's fertility, for instance. Heritage sites are sources of historical pride, indigenous knowledge, and cultural and religious identity. They are also a source of income through tourism. Losing this heritage may lead to identity and psychological crises. It could lead to rage and trauma, cultural shocks, and social collapse. The economic benefits from tourism could also be lost. Finally, some heritage objects like manuscripts are epistemological tablets. They carry evidence of world history. The destruction wipes out critical insights into humanity's past. Lucy Kasser on the dangers journalists face for uncovering truths in war. The Ethiopian reporter lives in exile because of her articles from Tigray, updated May 3, 2022. The Economist. More than a year has passed since I first uncovered evidence of war crimes in the continuing conflict in the Tigray region of northern Ethiopia. Civilians have endured atrocities including sexual violence, ethnic cleansing, systematic massacres, unspeakable torture and starvation. The horror stories are endless. Yet Ethiopia's government denies them. All sides of the conflict have committed war crimes. A mound of evidence gathered by investigative journalists and rights groups suggests that Ethiopian government troops, allied soldiers from Eritrea and local Amhara forces have committed terrible atrocities against ethnic Tigrayans. These acts could potentially amount to genocide, as defined in international law. Now, the butcher Abiy Ahmed is spreading lies to sharing his liabilities with TPLF troops. Abiy invited Eritrean, Somalian, troops, all Amhara Shifta Fano and militia and all 10 regional states militias and police, ENDF, Turkey drones, China drones, UAE drones, Ukraine and Russia armaments and SPYs. He invaded his own country and he deployed all TH's gangsters into Afar and Amhara. He ordered them to dehumanize the people and now accusing TPLF's forces to share his criminal liabilities, but he blocked the involvement of independent investigation. Why he cried to see independent investigation if he is innocent should be asked by reasonable person. But reasonable journalists are asking him questions like who bombed with drones thousands of civilians in Afar and Amhara, while Abiy Ahmed is the only owner of drones in the Horn of Africa. Other genociders and Abiy Ahmed affiliated medias are not even asked like reasonable questions. They only repeat the lies of Abiy Ahmed like a parrot. They don't like to ask questions like who is liable to the massacre of Eritreans in Amhara region the last week. They don't like to ask questions like who abducted and raped thousands of Muslims in Gondar this week. They are fearing the arrest of the butcher Abiy Ahmed and lying to save their lives. And to secure the bread of their parents. However, this is against the ethics of journalism.
As Tigray aid blockade continues, nearby areas also in desperate need of aid. VOA, the voice of America now, the voice of Amhara in practice, is crying for the people near Tigray while Tigrayans are dying of man-made starvation for near 2 years. VOA is the most deceptive and liar media in the Horn of Afrika. Here is the details.
Despite Ethiopia's declared humanitarian ceasefire with Tigrayan forces, aid groups are struggling to get food and medicine to those in need. Even outside the worst affected areas in Tigray, which are cut off to reporters, providing aid is fraught with risks and challenges. For VOA, Henry Wilkins reports from Desi, Ethiopia. Camera, Henry Wilkins.
In Ethiopia's northern Amhara region, it's been 4 months since occupying forces of the Tigray People's Liberation Front, or TPLF, left the area. As the region recovers from a brutal civil war, the UN says some 9.4 million people in the Amhara region and neighbouring Afar and Tigray regions need humanitarian assistance, but aid has been slow to arrive. 17-year-old Ahmed Nuru was living in the Oromia region, but he says he fled after facing persecution for his Amhara ethnicity. He lost his mother when he was young. Last year, his father died after being unable to get life-saving treatment due to the war's impact on the local healthcare system. Now he is left to take care of his two sisters, 10 and 8.
I have no idea what the future will look like. It's really very difficult. I don't know how I'm going to meet the responsibility of raising these two children.
Daniel Tigabu is a public health officer based in the camp for the displaced where Ahmed lives.
We don't have enough medical equipment or medicines. The center is running out of basic medical kits. There is a shortage of malaria kits, hepatitis kits, and HIV testing kits.
There are tens of thousands living in camps for the displaced in the Amhara region. Others live in host communities like Tizgenet Tibebu, who lost her husband.
Currently, we rely on what my husband's friends provided us on a piecemeal that includes my monthly house rent. I have nothing. I am a housewife. I am just waiting for any support, anything, to raise my two children. I feel I should pay a monthly house rent, even though the owners give me charity since I lost my husband. How can I plan for the future when I have nothing?
An aid worker in the hike camp says that stories like Ahmed's and Tegeznet's are not uncommon across the Amhara region.
The current situation makes us cry day and night. If you're hungry, you can't sleep. You're always thinking about your empty stomach. I've seen displaced people forced to sell pans or mattresses to survive. Things are really at a critical stage.
About 30,000 people displaced by conflict live just north of Hike in Weldia. A local government representative explains why aid is taking so long to arrive.
There was a little support at the beginning upon TPLF leaving after the area was a conflict zone for months. Aid has been distributed only twice since then. The aid provided either by the UN or the federal government is not enough.
North of the Amhara region, in Tigray, where journalists are banned from entering, the UN says the situation is worse, with famine-like conditions. Tigray is under a de facto humanitarian blockade, according to the UN. For now, all Ahmed and his sisters can do is try to scrape by and hope more assistance arrives soon. Henry Wilkins for VOA News, Hike, Ethiopia. Voy a sorbir un chilón de la vaca.